and appreciate you watching. Today I'm headed over to Alkaloo, or right outside of Alkaloo, to pick up a, it's like a grapple truck, Peterbilt. It's having some antifreeze issues. It's going somewhere. The guy keeps having to add water. So these trucks are pretty heavy. So I'm out in our B150-ton Peterbilt wrecker. And we're going to get it picked up and get it over to the Peterbilt dealership. This truck, is, like I said, is pretty heavy, so you have to pick it up frontwards and pull your drive shaft, run air, and all the normal stuff. But we'll give you a few minutes riding in, and we'll see you on scene. Something you don't see a lot of these days, people dissing land like they used to. John Deere 4960. You don't mind me videoing it, do you, Mr. Jerry? You don't mind me videoing it?
No,
our little
no.
YouTube channel, and we got a new driver. Everyone he can see that helps train him, so.
Well, I had to watch. Truck trying to recognize this view. It's been back here before.
It's been behind it, yes, sir.
And I didn't make it very far this morning.
You think the EGR is going out, or?
I don't know what's going. You know, it's a Packard engine.
Yes, sir.
And the way they're designed, you have to put about a gallon of water down every week. I was off last Friday. I went out there Friday afternoon and put water in it. I said, that's better than Monday morning with the skeeters eating me.
Yes, sir.
And it only took a half a jug. I said, somebody right. And down in Charleston yesterday, that little radiator come on, it started bunging. Every time I stopped at a traffic light, as long as I was moving, it went off. So I came home.
Yes, sir. My small Miller forks here to grab the front axle. And I want these forks right between the two U-bolts here. They bad at my house right now, they. There's some grown mosquitoes.
Yeah, but at my house, I can go inside.
Yes, sir.
I can't tell you how to do that, eh? Well, I said I'd be there, but it's getting hot without air conditioning. The sun's shining right in that windshield.
Thank you.
it in neutral, Mr. Jerry?
Yeah, it had a brakes on it, Bill.
I'll jump up there and grab him. Now I'm gonna remove the dry shaft so I don't have any mess up anything on the transmission. I always want to make sure you don't have any play in your, I mean you want to have play in your drive shaft. Because if it's loaded up, it will jump off and hurt you once you pull it out. A lot of people stick a gun right on this thing, but I like to break them by hand, that way I can feel them. This is a dry shaft, buddy. I don't know if y'all, if this is on any of our videos or not. I love this little tool here. Drop the dry shaft. It just lets your dry shaft hang in place. Thank you. shaft out. 2, 4, and 2. I always like to put my drive shaft bolts and straps in the seat. That way I don't ever have to worry about taking them out my truck. Where were you headed to this morning, Mr. Jerry?
Charleston. Well, first I was supposed to be going to Andrews, but I come out the house headed to the shop in Sumter with that light blinking.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, the guy we got that lives down there that does all that Charleston work. He had a little heart attack 3 weeks ago.
Oh my goodness, he doing all right?
Yeah, they just put some stents in him. He's wanting to come back to work and the doctor says he's got to wait. You know how that goes.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
What's
the
engine
rate on that car? 48,000 to 50,000, according to how much fuel and all is in it.
Well, this one's 41, almost 42, so ain't a whole lot of difference.
No, sir.
That's what we need to hear, is you ain't got one.
Sir?
That's what we need to hear, is you ain't got one.
Yes, sir.
I ain't seeing you find one.
Yeah, I found one. It just ain't in the box where it's supposed to be.
The only thing I know to do is let's quit this job and go to the beach fishing.
That sounds good. In your truck before I forget it. All right. I'll put my safety chains on, Mr. Jerry, and we'll be ready to ride. Tie my steering wheel off. God forbid something happened, but just hold it straight behind my truck. So are you ready?
Yeah, how much room you got in that floorboard, you reckon?
I got a little bit.
I'm gonna get my lunchbox and my little bag in there.
Yeah, we'll make room.
It's only got to ride 2 miles.
All right.
Okay, viewers, we'll be back with you. We are just about to the Peterbilt place over in Florence. Probably be riding about 45 minutes or so. We get this truck dropped off and go in and check with the service guy, see if they want us to reinstall the drive shaft. I really don't like to reinstall them because that kind of holds us liable. But if they, some places require that we put them back in, I'll put them back in, but I ask them to go behind us and torque our, make sure our bolts are torqued to the right specs. Off at this exit right here. Notice I have to flip a switch. Our tracks along this truck does not turn, so when I'm turning I have to pick the axle up, and once I get back straight I can drop it back down just to help stop it. The KW V100 that we have, it actually turns. I didn't drop the axle back down there because we were only going, as you saw, just a little piece. So wasn't no big deal, and Peterbilt is right up here around the curve.
Just the process of reversing everything we've already done. Thank you. service manager. He wrote it on his sheet to double check our bolts. Drive shaft bolts. Don't have a torque wrench, and every truck has like different specs. So torque them enough they can move it in the shop. Get my air gun, because that's a handy tool. All right, let's go through our checklist. We got our drive shaft back in, the air plug in the tank, put our forks up, safety chains are up, lights are off the back. We got our pin back in place on our wheel lift. That should be everything. Truck number 106. Okay, folks, that's the drop off. Okay, viewers, hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to comment, share, like, and if you like our content and channel, please subscribe. And as always, stay safe out there, and we'll catch you on the next one.